Or they're telling the truth, and the devil has actually decided not to bother them because he already has them on his calendar. Either way, go get sealed. Somebody help me with the number of the rules. Put your name and tell them persecution. Persecution is a part of the journey. What makes you so special? Let me help you so you know you're in good company. Even Jesus had some dark days. Preacher, when I'm trying to get my bozo back, when he had to get to himself and retreat to the side of the mountain and revive himself. In fact, you can't even reign with him. The Bible says that he only learned how to suffer with him. You're supposed to have those moments. You need God, but I'll help you. He said it himself. Take up your cross. But I'm not bothering tonight if you don't need it, God, and I do understand. I'm only going to need tonight. For those of us like me who have Paul-like testimonies who would declare since being saved, help me, Lord, I've had to die daily. You know, like the Bible where somebody ought to say, all my life I had to die. I had to die daily. In fact, he gives us an example in this same chapter, verse 32. I had to read the whole chapter in order to be contextually correct. In verse 32, he gives us an example of having to war while on this journey. He says, I'm justifiably tired. See, somebody in this world knows that you got every right to feel how you feel. God help you today. I can't stand it for them to come up to me and try to tell me how to feel before they know the circumstances that put me in my feelings. Listen, if you don't know what to say to me, mind your business and pay no business. And if you don't know what it took to get my head up, that's why you're not bothering people when they drag themselves in the church. Look at somebody tell them, just be mad. Yes,
hallelujah.
Glory to God. Amen. Amen. It is. Mind your business. Leave me alone. He said, I am justifiably tired. He said, I've been serving the Lord, yet I still had to fight with the beast at Ephesus. Where I want you to try to start naming all the beasts that we've had. The fact that I do know, he purposely listed the location. He said at Ephesus. And I don't want to listen to you, man, but I want to remind you that at Ephesus, watch this, there was a city and there was a church. Preacher, I'm trying. And I won't linger there too long, but it bears to mention that because not everybody in church has Christ.
That's right.
Amen. Sometimes you'll find yourself fighting for your life in the street and in the sanctuary.
Yes. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
That often, but sometimes, Pastor, I need revival not only in church, but revival from church. I don't think anybody here has ever been in such a leadership position. I wonder if there are any leaders in the room that ever felt like your assignment and people were sucking the life right out of you. Well, you all chose this scripture, so let me preach what you gave me. I love that you all chose this verse for service this week because at the post-examination, the Spirit revealed to me its true connection. At first, when I looked at it, I said, I don't get it because that scripture and standing alone is a wonderful scripture. But if I read it contextually, I actually thought that I was going to present it from an exegetical standpoint. I was going to read the text and bring something to the text that we could give God glory and go home. And I am an exegetical preacher by nature, which means that when you read the text, you must do your due diligence to not only read the text, but read the pretext. Reading the pretext, that there is a post-text that is necessary to read. You read that so that you can handle the text. So, the good I can give it is I had the nerve, Pastor, to read the pretense, and then I read the whole chapter, not all the Vishnu chapter, but I read the whole chapter, and it was after reading it that I saw the true connection. This powerful verse actually serves as the climactic crescendo, the exclamation point on a chapter of scripture, here it is, that takes the time to clearly explain the revival of resurrection. Now we're in this season, so I don't feel too out of place telling you that this scripture is really Paul's way of explaining everything he can about resurrection. Help me make sure you're in the room. Put this about quickly and tell him, I'm dying to get up.
Put me out, but I got to say it because we all say